In this illustration, we'll discuss the case 3 of a gas undergoing a cyclic process. This is a different case compared to the previous two. Here, we are given that an ideal diatomic gas undergoes the cycle shown in the indicator diagram, when we are required to find the efficiency of the cycle. Again, to get the efficiency of cycle, we need to calculate the work done by gas in the cycle and heat supplied to the gas, or the total heat which is absorbed by the gas. Here, on carefully analyzing this case, we can see in the process A to B, as temperature is rising, heat will be supplied to the gas. In the process B to C, here you can see the gas is being compressed and temperature is constant. So, this is an isothermal process. And we can see as pressure is reduced, the volume must be increasing. So, this is the process where heat is again absorbed by the gas or supplied to the gas. But from C to A, as temperature is decreasing at constant pressure, heat will be rejected by the gas. So, this initial analysis is quite important to understand. Now, we can calculate in solution step by step for all processes. First, we can talk about for process AB. Here, in process AB, if we talk, this is a straight line passing through origin. So, this AB will be an isochoric process. As this is an isochoric process, we can directly write down, this implies work done in process AC is equals to 0. And if we calculate the heat supplied to the gas in process AC, this will be equals to nCV delta T, which is TB minus TA. So, here in terms of TA, we can write as here pressure is increased to 3 times. As volume is constant, temperature will also become 3 times. So, here we can write TB is equals to TC is equals to 3 times TA. So, we substitute it here. This will give us the heat supplied in the process AB. Here we are talking about the process AB. So, in this process AB, it is N. And the value of CV for a diatomic gas, we can write as 5R by 2. Multiplied by TB, we can write as 3TA. So, it will be 2TA. Which gives us the value 5nRTA as the heat supplied in the process A to B. Now, if we talk about for process BC, then here you can see in process BC, temperature is constant. This is an isothermal process. And we know in isothermal process, no change in internal energy is there. So, in this case, the work done and heat supplied will be equal. So, here we can write WBC is equals to heat supplied in the process BC, which can be directly given by the relation NRTB ln of V final by V initial. Here we can see in the process BC as temperature is constant and pressure is reduced to 1/3 of the initial value, that means volume will increase to 3 times. Here we can write VC will be equals to 3 times VB as pressure is 1/3 of VB. So, ln of we can write VC upon VB. So, this can be given as NR. TB we can write as 3TA multiplied by ln 3. So, this is the value of heat supplied as well as work done we are getting in the process BC. So, if we calculate further for process CA, which is an isobaric process, here in isobaric process, we can calculate the work done as the work done can directly be written as the pressure multiplied by change in volume. So, PWCA is equals to pressure in C2A is P multiplied by this we can write as VA minus VC, and we already have VC is 3 times VB. So, in this situation, this rather than calculating volume at state A, we write it in terms of temperature as PVA, we can write as NR, TN, PVC is NRTC, so that can be written as TA minus TC. If we substitute the value of TC over here, which is 3TA, the work done we are getting in the process CA is minus 2NRTA. You can see all values we are transforming in terms of TA, so that when we take the ratio of work to heat supplied for efficiency, TA gets cancelled out. Now, as we have got these values, we don't need to calculate the heat supplied in CA as it is negative or it is rejected, which is not required for calculation of efficiency. Here, we can simply write total work done by gas in cycle is, so total work done is sum of the three works WAB plus WBC plus WCA. So we sum it up, this gives us 3NRTA ln 3 minus 2NRTA. Similarly, here we can calculate the heat supplied to gas in cycle. This Q we can write as sum of these two heats, which are QAB plus QBC. So the numerical values we are having is 5NRTA plus the same value of work done in isothermal processes, 3NRTA ln 3. Now we can calculate the cycle efficiency eta as work done upon heat supplied, and we multiply it by 100 for percentage. So substituting these values, we can directly get 3 ln of 3 minus 2 divided by 5 plus 3 ln of 3 multiplied by 100%, that is the result of this problem.